All right, guys, Mr. Saving the Day here, and I'm just continuing on with the reloading of these 9mm. Where I left off, I think you saw, is I've got the old primers out. I've sized it. I've got the neck size to accept the bullet, the right size. I've also, since the last step, I did get a tumbler. So I put them through the tumbler, so everything's nice and shiny now. And now I'm putting the primers in. And basically what we're doing in this step is taking your cartridge that's got the hole through it, you can see there. What we're going to do is we're going to put in the primer in the bottom, and the next step will be powder. So what I've done is I've gotten small pistol primers, and I've loaded them into a hand primer loader. And what you do is the primers all line up inside this special disc here, and they feed in, and we simply take the cartridge, set it on there, get a primer to go in, give it a squeeze, just a little oomph at the end there, and your primer is, I don't know if it's going to focus, your primer seated. And now we just keep doing that until we do the whole bunch. I don't know if you see where I pull them over here. I keep real organized. Over here I've got the ones that are all the tumbler. This is my powder thrower. I'm priming them that I'm putting over here in another chart, in another holder when I'm done. So I know what's been done and what hasn't been done. But I'm going to go through here. And so you guys know, let me pull this up. There's a little pin in here that moves up and down. Just a note. This pin has two sides, a round side and a flat side. The flat side has to be up. Just remember that. You don't want the primers going off. Be careful. I know some guys prime using the actual loader, but I have this. It came with the kit, so I'm going to use it and use, you know, what I have available to me. It's pretty quick. I'll do these pretty quick. And it's easy enough. Just line them up, give it a nice firm squeeze, primer's in, on to the next one. I'll be back in a little bit. Alright guys, hope you can see this. I know I'm real tight on these shots here and everything. I got limited room here on the bench, but I just ran out of primers into the loader, so I just wanted to show you. I don't know if you can see this. There are little ribs on this, and if you shake it, the primers all end up the right way. And then once they end up the right way, that is explosive side coming up, you know, into the cartridge you're going to be loading, you can put the lid on. There's just a little hole there you got to match it up with. And there, the lid is on. Now they're all in place. They'll all stay the right side up. And then I can continue right on where I left off. You can see down here how far I am along. And then over there you can probably barely see. I got 15, 20 more. I think I just dumped 20 more in. So we'll see how far that gets us. I'll be back in a second. Alright guys, I've got everything primed. All the cartridges are primed and ready to go. Everything looks good. It's nice with a hand primer because it's all feel. Yeah, you can feel that primer sliding into the pocket and just give it a nice little just a little push with the handle there, and you can feel it seat real nice where it has a definite positive contact into the pocket. And now we're on to the next step. there's a book here I'm going to show you in a second that's going to show you your different powders and everything, but that's how I decided what I'm going to use. I am using a 9mm 124 grain bullet. So the next thing that you have to do is go into your manual, and here's the one that came with mine, the reloading manual, and I'm under the 9mm section here, and I find the 124 grain bullets that I'm using, and with those it lists over here the different types of powder and then the different types of and the weight of powder I'm going to put in the charge. Alright, sorry about that. Since I'm using, see if I can show you here, when you look in the book, I'm using number 5, so I have a start charge of 5.7 and a max of 6.4. Well, I want to get between those two numbers and no higher than, of course, your max charge. So now I've got to set up my powder thrower here to throw the right charge. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to fill this probably 3/4 of the way and maintain that 3/4 of the way full. If I take it too low, I want to have the same amount of weight coming down through here so that every time I throw a charge, I'm going to get the same amount of powder coming out the bottom. And what I'm going to do first is I am going to take, I'm going to have to pick up and insert, I have a scale, I got a scale over here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to throw powder into the gold cup there and weigh it until this thing is throwing the right amount of charge every time. And then after that, I can roll with loading it directly from here into my cartridges. And then they'll be ready for the next step, which will be putting the bullet on top of each one of them and seating the bullet and crimping it. Setting the bullet and crimping it. So, you know, that's where we're at. So right now I got to get that load right, though, and make sure I'm putting the right amount of powder in this thing every time. So I'm going to mess around with that here for a second and maybe show you as I'm doing that how I'm doing it, and you can kind of see the way it works. And all right, I'll be right back. All right, guys, let me show you what I got going on. You have to be very repetitive and do everything the same way if you want the charge to come out the same way. So what I do is I tap at the bottom of the stroke. When I get to the top, I tap it again. And now this is where it throws the charge when I come down. I'm going to get a certain amount come out. I'm going to give it a tap. And then from here, I'm going to take it over to my scale, which I've set, and see what I'm coming up with. And right now I'm not throwing near what I have to. I want 5.9 grains, and I need quite a bit more thrown in there. So now I have to make adjustments till it does start throwing the right amount of grains. All right, guys, I got it dialed in here now, and let me zoom in here now. What I got is every time I'm throwing some, when I throw it into the gold, when I throw it in, I'm getting the same thing, 5.9 grains. And that's where I want to have consistency. So I did a lot of it. You can see I got some powder here I need to clean up. But it was, I got consistent. Now I'm getting 5.9, 5.9, 5.9, 5.9. Now I'm going to start filling the cartridges. And it takes a little bit to get to that point. But now that it's set up, I can go right through. What I'll do after that is I'm going to check each one of them. Here, just put a flashlight in there, make sure I've got the same amount of powder in each one. Nothing's double charged, but seeing as I'm keeping it very organized, they're going to go from here, and then I'm going to have another block over here that's going to have that I'll use, and that's going to have my powdered ones with the powder that are charged here, and then from here they'll go into the press, and where I'll seat, and I'll show you how to do that, and from there they're going to go into the holder. That I'll box up, and what I usually do is write down exactly what I have going on in the box. So 124 grain, 5.9 grains of powder, 100 primer, and using number 5 powder. Anyways, that's it. And alright, I'm going to throw some of these. I'm going to set it down, maybe let you guys watch. Alright, guys, moving right along here.
kind of do it very robotically, like I'm a machine. Same tip, the same tap. Just move through them. I can see the powder in them. It's all looking level. Keeping organized. Going from my left to my right. Making sure I throw that same charge in there once in a while. I'll do a check. And just make sure. Put it on the scale over there. And check it out. It is 5.9 right on the button. Open up. Put the power back in. Top back on, and back at it. Cartridge up. Swing the arm. Like I said, every once in a while I don't do one of these, and I'll go and do I'll throw it right into the weight there and take a weight. But give you a view here. You can see the powder in there. You can kind of tell that it's all at the right level. All looks even. That's what you want to look for. That's what I'll take the flashlight for. Check it out too, make sure it all looks nice and even. And let me do the rest of these. And I'll get back to you when I'm done.
Got everything charged. We're just going to seat the bullet and crimp it, and we'll be done. And that'll be 50 rounds.
And just thought I'd show you my powder thrower real quick. What I did was take the RCBS mount that came in there, mounted it to a 2x4, got me just high enough off of the, to work with easily enough, and used the adapter on there that funnels it right into the bullet, and mounted the whole thing on a board, and put some rubber stoppers on the bottom of it, and actually kept the cardboard box that it comes in, made a spot here. Can set it right in there, and then that goes down there underneath my press, and keeps it out of the way, keeps it covered up, keeps everything nice. Let me clean up the bench here, and we'll go on to the next spot, the next part.
All right, guys, for this next step here, we're going to be setting this thing up to seat the bullets, and I've got the bullet seater in place there, and what we'll do. Try and show you here, best I can, everything that's going on. But what I did was, we have to make sure that we're making the actual 9mm cartridge to spec. So in the beginning of the book here, in the 9mm section, it gives us dimensions. And basically for the bullet here, we need to be within a certain length. And what I did was set up calipers to get me within the length that I need to be. So I'm seating the bullet to the proper depth. And also with the crimp, there's a dimension too with the crimp. And what I did is I set up two calipers, one with the length, so I'm making sure that I'm seating to the right depth, and then one with the neck size. And basically,
there's the as you can see, as I go back, it stops. So I have to get it crimped to here. And what I did was, this is a Federal load. This is American Eagle. Their crimp is nice. PMC. And Blazer. And then lengthwise setup, the same thing. There's the Blazer. There's PMC. American Eagle, which is Federal. And then an actual Federal round. So I want mine to be dimensionally correct. So for the 124 grains, they give you a dimension. That all needs to be as far as the length on it. And each bullet's going to have a different length that it needs to be. So make sure that you're watching what that is. And I guess the maximum cartridge overall length is 1.169. So we don't want to be more than that because we'll have feeding issues. And then the bullet will be sitting into the neck and into the barrel too far. So next we'll get this set up for seating bullets. And there's a little cheat for that. What we're going to do is we're actually going to use a cartridge and set this up. Now, I've already set it up, but what's going to happen is the cartridge is going to go up in. What you're going to do is adjust this down until you feel it start crimping the cartridge. And then you're going to set this up till it starts touching the top of the bullet. So you'll feel it get tight here first. You're going to set that up and then adjust the seater down till you to feel it touch the top of the bullet. So we're kind of cheating. We're figuring it out. Now I did move this down an eighth of an inch once I used this up into there and put that bullet or that cartridge up into there to feel where it is that it starts crimping. And so I get a nice crimp. And anyways, there we go. So that's you'll go into more depth. The book explains all this. Do what the book says. Do what your dies say to do and how to do it. Basically, that's what we're doing. What we need to do is get the bullet into the right length, and we need to crimp the bullet in place. And we want to make sure we do that with the 9mm, just because of the nature of the 9mm, and you're feeding it up the magazine. And with the shock and everything else, you want that bullet to remain in the right spot. And with the RCBS, it's in one step. Other presses have two different dies that you put in to accomplish that. But RCBS, it's just the one step here, and we'll get it to the right length. And let me start doing some of these, and then I'll get back to you. All right, guys, did a couple here. And everything came out good. And just show you what I got here. Okay, I've got my length set at 1.156. So I know that I'm under the max length that the bullet can be of 1.169. And that's kind of a check I'm doing on it. And then at my crimp, I have to be at 0.381, something like that. And I know I shouldn't say something like that. I'm sorry. Anyways, I've got that set at what the factory does. So I know that I'm getting a nice crimp on it. And it's real easy then at that point. Then you're just, here you go. Set the bullet right on. And since you flared the case, the bullet sits on there nice, up and in. Crimp, set the bullet. Cartridge comes down. We check our length. We're within tolerance on our length. And when we check the cartridge at the neck, it's good. And as you go back, you can see it. See, so we're getting the right crimp on it here. And easy enough, we just keep on rolling through. Load nines. A nice firm, little push down, come down. Check the length. Check the crimp. Everything's good. Now that I got it rolling here, that's number four. I am just going to probably do a check every row here it should move right along now. Looks good. Glad I got the bullet tumbler. And like I said, then I check my length. Check my crimp. Put it in the tray. And we move on. I'll be back when I'm done. Alright guys, there you go. 49, anyway. I know I started this video probably 2 months ago. And like I said, it's not a rush. I've got 1,200 rounds of manufactured stuff that I have to shoot, or I could shoot, that is brass that I could, you know, feed this now, that I'm doing the reloading of the 9. And I've got plenty of brass already put through the tumbler. I divided it up by the different brands, and it's ready to go. And I mean, it can go through everything that we just did tonight, putting this together. The reason I have 49 and not 50 is, I don't know if this will zoom in there, but for some reason it seated this bullet a little bit off, and I think it's the bullet. It's actually not how it got seated. It felt funny going in. I gave it a little extra muscle, and when it came out, I noticed that it's off. I think the bullet is actually manufactured weird. I buy the bullets by the thousand, but the primers by the thousand, and the brass, I did have to buy some once loaded brass, like I said, or once fired brass, like I said, to get started. But I won't ever have to buy brass now, just looking to see what I got coming in. And as I'm shooting, I'm trying to shoot my brass, keep the aluminum, and because I can reload it. But here's what the rounds look like. I mean, beautiful round. Now I got the itch to go shooting. So, how am I going to save the day? I'm going to learn how to reload, especially if I'm a shooter and I'm out there shooting these. It's much more cost effective, especially now. And I know there's some trouble getting product, but it's all coming back into stock different places. And all you have to do is do some digging. I've done videos where you do some digging. You know, you can find good holsters if you don't go to the place that everyone else is going. There's guys out there looking for your bullet or for your business. I used, for the bullets, I used Barry's Bullets on it. And I found some places, a place in Wyoming, actually, that got me the once fired brass for a bargain. But definitely, I am way lower than half the price on that box right there that you're looking at. And I am including in all my startup stuff. So, but it's something you need to learn if you're shooting. Anyways, hope this video helps you out. Like I said, follow the manual. It's going to tell you everything you need to know. And Mr. Saving the Day, out.